actually become the third wheel on our romantic European vacation.
I honestly thought Deanna was the third wheel. Was I wrong?
How did you end up becoming the third wheel on our romantic European vacation?
Right? I honestly don't remember how it came about. It was, hey, let's go to Europe. Let's just go do it. Yeah, we're gonna spend 5 weeks there.
The country on our first stop is Wales.
But first, you have to land in London and
rent a car.
And then get on the road and brave the crazy other side.
How are you feeling about driving so far?
Intense, man.
White knuckling it.
Oh, this is.
That just so you just so you know, you missed the lower level and exit sign.
Where was that?
We just passed it. Look, kid.
The Big Ben. Am I driving around in a circle?
I believe you are. Soon the real fun's gonna begin.
Yeah.
GPS signal lost.
Curb.
What was Vince like driving on the wrong side of the road? Well, that was interesting. So he was hitting bushes. You can feel the tension in the car because we're all just like, Vince is gonna hit something. Vince is gonna hit something. Watch out.
I didn't hit anything though.
Well, the mirror, you don't.
Well, yeah, but I didn't damage the car. I hit.
That they know of.
Ah, crap!
How you doing?
Not, man. Not. Why did he stop?
Because roundabout, you're supposed to keep going, right? Isn't that the point of a roundabout?
Yeah.
Once we finally made it safely to our friend Vince's house.
What do you mean safely? We made it there fine.
Uh-huh.
Then we went to the grocery store to stock up on some food.
We are here in Wales at the market of Sainsbury.
Candy is like on a whole different level here.
That's the truth.
The Europeans really take their candy seriously.
That's for sure.
There was like aisles of just nothing but sweets.
And their sweets seem to be on a whole other level.
Crazy. And there was like aisles of cookies too.
Oh my God, so good. But the staple of our trip turned out to be Maltesers.
We ate these things like every day.
Every day. We had to bring some home with us.
Every day we hit the market to stock back up on Maltesers.
On Maltesers. They're so good.
It's like a Whopper, but
only better. They just melt in your mouth. Oh, so good.
So after a full belly of candy and a good night's sleep, the following morning,
our Welsh friend Vince treated us to a real
the other Vince
English breakfast.
And then he took us around Wales to show us the sights.
Yeah.
We're on our way to Mumbles, right?
Mumbles, yeah. Mumbles, just west of Swansea.
What are we gonna do in Mumbles?
Have a coffee and have a walk on the seafront.
It is a beautiful day and we're here at Mumbles Beach and there's the lighthouse. Pitch the lighthouse, pitch it.
Are you enjoying your?
My peppermint tea, it's delicious.
And Michael's having tea?
I am having my tea.
You can have it like that. You're milking. Proper business.
I will have some because I'm supposed to be proper.
And the local is having coffee.
Filtered?
Filtered coffee. And I'm having water. Which one's your favorite girl? What do you like? You like the boys? Which one do you? Did you bring your Velcro gloves?
I did.
You did?
Hi. What's that?
Why would he take us to sheep?
I'm pretty sure it was to show off all the girls he's done. I think that's probably what it was. Because he always carries a pair of Velcro gloves in his car, and I was wondering what that was about.
Why would they, what do you mean by Velcro gloves?
Well, they have the Velcro has the hooks part on it, so he just goes straight up to the sheep and slams them together. so they can't get away. And then sometimes he'll take them to the edge of a cliff, so that way they back up. So Vince has Velcro gloves in his car all the time.
Hey, I guess it can get lonely in Wales.
Vince took us to the most American restaurant that Wales has to offer, aside from McDonald's.
Yeah, isn't that weird? That is the smallest
It's vacation, so it's zero calories.
Yeah, that's right.
Yep. Zero calories.
Yeah. It's like 678 calories.
The next day, the jet lag had fully worn off, and it was time to really dive in and explore Wales.
It's our first train ride in the UK.
We're on the tube.
You almost walked right in front of a car.
Yeah, when you get over there, they keep saying, look right, look right, look right.
You're looking left right now.
Well, it takes a while to sink in.
Just gonna die. Anyway, in Cardiff, they had this awesome street that was covered in glass to protect you from the rain elements.
Yes, but the greatest thing was, in Cardiff, they've got a castle. And ever since I was a little girl, I was always fascinated with castles and medieval times and dragons. So it's always been a lifelong dream of mine to actually go and see and visit a real castle.
My dream is to visit tropical locations where she wears little to no clothes.
And if you're gonna visit one castle, why not visit a bunch?
It would be awesome if castles were located on tropical beaches.
The highest concentration of castles is in Wales.
I have no idea why kings were insistent on claiming cold lands.
Wales once had about 400 castles.
Like Game of Thrones, all those castles are in cold areas. Like one is even called Winterfell.
Over 100 castles are still standing in Wales.
At least Daenerys is smart enough to claim a castle in a land that's hot, where she's naked all the time.
Her goal is to conquer Westeros.
But once she realizes and remembers how friggin' cold it is there, she'll hightail it back to the nude beach.
Whatever. Our first castle is Cardiff Castle.
We're at Cardiff Castle, which I didn't expect to be right next to a Burger King.
Okay, welcome everybody. Welcome to Cardiff Castle. My name is Chris, apparently. Yes, that's my name.
I know what you're thinking. This castle does not look medieval.
Well, here's the weird thing about Cardiff Castle. It was built over 900 years ago in the late 1100s, but it was lived in until 1947.
So the castle was actually renovated through the years and therefore doesn't appear to be so medieval.
Yeah, so actually, with all the renovations, the castle's more of a Victorian Gothic revival mansion.
I wonder what that HGTV show is like. Castle renovations.
Shh. We're in the library at Cardiff Castle.
is the Arab room here at Cardiff Castle. It's pretty amazing.
Were there Arabs here?
I don't know, but it's gold leaf. The ceiling. It's pretty cool.
Do the Arabs have gold?
I think the Arabs had a lot of gold.
Did they put it all here?
Apparently.
Why are you so excited?
This is my first circular staircase in a castle.
Ah, the loo, the privy. But during medieval times, it looked like this and was called the guard robe. Can you imagine pooping down a hole like that?
Ugh, and whose job was it to clean it up at the bottom?
What about the people who took shelter in the castle walls?
Yeah?
Where did they poop?
We're inside the walls of Cardiff.
During World War II, the walls of Cardiff Castle were used to give people shelter from possible air bomb raids. Could you imagine living or staying, you know, for an extended period of time within these walls? In certain sections, bunk beds were placed up against the walls where people could stay. Being in here and hearing all the sound blasts and the air sirens going on, it's just kind of eerie.
That was super eerie.
How many people bunked in those walls?
About 1,800.
I bet these stones are older than American stones.
Like the trebuchet? How far could that chunk of pumpkin?
Exactly what that part of the castle is, but it's still part of Cardiff Castle. We have to go get the audio tour.
It was the tower built on the hill or something like that. I think it's so they to defend the castle so they could see.
Tis the keep of Cardiff Castle. Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
It is I, Vince.
You are not Romeo.
You dissed me.
Aw, you're my Romeo.
Yeah. This is the view from the top of the castle keep.
It's quite the vantage point to defend the castle from intruders.
It's weird to see this place surrounded by a modern city. Skyscrapers have a better vantage point. Look, there's a Starbucks.
I feel like a princess.
Princess Diana, the Princess of Wales.
So we come all the way from Hollywood, California to see people filming.
Who do we see?
The doctor.
It's the doctor.
Yeah. Who? The doctor.
Who?
Exactly, the doctor.
So we did the Doctor Who experience.
And what exactly is the Doctor Who experience?
The Doctor Who experience is you actually get to go into a TARDIS and you go on an adventure with Doctor Who.
Yeah, you're not allowed to videotape any of that, but you know, and then afterwards, they dumped us into the museum.
Yeah, and the museum is really cool too, because it's got all these artifacts and sets and things from the show.
We are here at the Doctor Who Museum. We just went through the Doctor Who experience, and these are his TARDISes. But which is the real room?
This is the who?
Who?
Doctor Who?
Doctor Who?
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 Doctor.
Who's the doctor?
Doctor.
So confused. Doctor
Who.
That's
what I
want to know. Who? The doctor. Doctor Who. Exactly.
Thank you.
They're just so alien. The aliens are so alien. And they're alien.
Good thing I didn't take you to the deep south.
Exterminate.
Don't put this one up your ass.
That's your.
I'll jerk you off.
That's your anal probe and plunger.
It might be like this, a little bit smaller. But still, I'm gonna go. Give me a hug. Come on, give me a hug. Hug me. Hug me. Number 5 is alive. I cannot kill. I like humans. A little bit closer. I can totally get this right in you. Oh yeah, right out there. That'd be perfect. Hello there. Hi.
My eyes are burning. I cannot stop looking. I cannot blink. I just blinked. I might be in trouble. Don't blink. Don't blink. Don't blink. I blinked.
That night we had a lovely dinner at Vince's friend's beach house.
His name is Mark, and he lived in Ogmore by the sea.
It was really pretty.
I have to write this stuff down. All these lingo terms, like a squash. Would you like, you know, a Coke or a squash or a... beer.
A Coke is a fizzy.
A Coke is a fizzy, and juice is a squash, you know? So it's, yeah.
And everything is lovely.
Everything's lovely or quite nice. It's quite nice.
And doing something the right way is doing
proper. Oh, lovely, thank you. Yeah, it's proper. You have to have proper English tea, you know, proper tea, proper coffee. You know, I'm digging it. I'm liking it, you know?
Like, you know, it's 112 miles the furthest away from any McDonald's you can be in California in the United States.
Is that right? It's 112 miles.
Actually, the furthest that you can get away from a McDonald's in America is in the middle of South Dakota. It's 107 miles to the nearest McDonald's.
And that's if you're flying by way of the crow, because it's really 145 miles by car.
This is the magnificent Pembroke Castle. Look at how majestic it is. It is huge. It's awesome, and I can't wait to see it. Let's go!
Yay! We visited a real castle!
Yeah, this castle was awesome! It was filled with real ancient history.
Well, medieval history.
Yeah, exactly. That's ancient history.
Eh, well, okay.
Yeah. You know what? We should start every sentence with the word yeah.
Here we are at Pembroke Castle.
And what do we know?
It's awesome!
Well, what do we know about Pembroke Castle?
I'm here to learn about it.
We may not be the poshest castle in Britain, but we've done more here to upset world history than all the other castles in Britain.
We started building a stone castle from 1204 onwards. The man who built in stone was called William Marshall.
So in this castle, right here, there would have been a very large ditch. So the only way that you would have been able to get in this castle, to, if you're seizing and you wanted to capture it, would be via catapult. You would catapult into the gates, and then you would come into this first courtyard. And very carefully, mind you, catapults wouldn't work here because, again, there's nowhere to set up. There's not enough space. So the only way to then get in through these big doors, there's a series of three big wood, thick, heavy, sturdy doors. So this time, you would use the battering ram. So all the men would line up on the battering ram, and they'd use it to pound the doors and to get them open. However, you'd have to worry about, it would take, what, 7 hours or so. Meanwhile, you're getting rained down by arrows and arrows and arrows, and so you've got your shields, and you're trying to avoid the arrows, and you're battering the ram, and you get one of the doors open. Woohoo! Oh no! There's a second door! And what makes this door harder is you have to stand right here. You have to be very careful about where it's safe, because in these rooms here, they'd be throwing rocks at you and boiling acid, and swords are coming through these slats trying to stab you. You've got boiling acid coming down, raining down on you with rocks. Meanwhile, you've still got your shield, and you're battering. Boom! It comes open.
you run in. All right, we got it. We're in. No, you're not. You still have another door that you have to batter with more dangerous swords coming through here and more boiling acid. And if we manage to get through the third one, run in.
So
needless to say, nobody ever got through that way. Bistress. Hang on. This strategic fortress was a key site in a centuries-long struggle between the Norman lords and the princes of Durhambark. Durhambark.
We got a free guided tour of the castle.
Yeah, it was free.
Are we gonna do the yeah thing?
Yeah.
No.
So instead of slicing it the way we do, they sliced it top to bottom, yeah. Right? The nobleman got the best piece of bread. And the bread back in those days, the best piece, was very hard and thick. And they would not use plates. Instead, they would use this hard piece of bread. They would put all their food on top of it. The gravy would soak down into the bread, which would soften it. However, the noblemen would not eat the bread. Instead, they would package it up and they would give it to the poor to eat. Well, the upper crust was the best. And so the more important you were, you got the upper crust. And the further down the table you get, you know, the crust, it gets worse and worse and worse. But once you get down to the very end of the table, those crusts of bread did not go out to the poor. Instead, they would use those to feed the horses.
The electronic candles are kind of interesting.
In 1648, during the English Second Civil War, Oliver Cromwell's musketeers defeated John Poyer's musketeers and claimed the castle. Poyer,
that guy,
and a few other men were sentenced to death. They were ordered to draw lots.
Think lottery.
They refused, so a child handed each man his lot. Two read, life given by God, one was blank.
John Poyer?
Poyer.
Poyer. John Poyer. We'll call him John. Let's call him John. It's my buddy John here. He's got a piece of paper, had nothing written on it, which means he's going to die. If you pull the one without any words on it, you get killed by the other two people. Very sad.
It was very sad.
How do you know? Maybe he was a bad guy. Maybe he was like Joffrey Baratheon.
Maybe he was like Tyrion.
Oh, that would suck. I love that little guy. One of the things that makes Pembroke unique is its domed roofs.
What makes the domes unique?
You know, I'm glad you asked that.
Well?
The dome ceiling in this room would be used to collect water on the top. So this way they could survive for 11 months in this tower. The loo where you go poo. Another loo. Poo in the loo. This one has a light. So you don't have to poo in the dark. Oh look, there's a little alcove for toilet paper for the trees.
Ah, what is it with you and privies?
It's an essential part of medieval life. Mm. Where else would you throw your condoms?
Condoms aren't around then.
Actually, there's evidence of condoms in French caves that date back to 11,000 BC.
This is the Great Keep at Pembroke Castle. It is the largest of the circular keeps. We should go take a look.
We're here at the bottom of the Great Keep at Pembroke Castle. This was built for sieges. The door, main door to get into the tower was built up, I forgot how many feet, but this was so that they could not use battering rams to get in here.
All the towers and many of the buildings in the castles are built round because they're much stronger. And also, arrows, you can't go
you know, an arrow does not bend. So arrows only fly straight. So you've got a curvature of the staircase, you know, to protect from arrows.
And battering rams.
And battering rams. Top of the Great Keep here at Pembroke Castle. Below is the bay where ships had to come in and pay their taxes.
Yeah, I don't know.
Are we back to the yeah thing?
Yeah, if it were me, I would build a bikini beach castle. I don't get why kings were so obsessive over cold, rainy lands.
Well, they can farm the lands for food.
Yeah, but at the beach, a hottie will bring you a drink with an umbrella in it.
We're now in the dungeon tower at Pembroke Castle. This would be a cell. There's only one way in and one way out. You would lift up the door, put down a ladder, prisoner would go in, door would be shut. Occasionally they would get some food, but they would just live down in this pit full of darkness with a couple minor little meals. There was a story of one of the prisoners that was down here for 7 years, and when they let him out, he was blind. So, kind of sucks.
Kind of sucks?
Yeah.
What part of that doesn't fully suck?
We are at the top of the dungeon tower.
It's very narrow. To the Great Hall.
Well, it wouldn't have been. It would have had a roof.
Well, yeah.
Fireplace and the fireplace.
This is the Great Norman Hall at Pembroke Castle. There are many famous people who were right here. Famous kings. King John, for one. But he was a nasty, nasty man.
Nasty, nasty.
Right.
Nasty.
Very nasty, right. He is the King John of the Robin Hood times.
Hey, the Kevin Costner version is the bomb.
Men in Tights was still a good version.
Well, that's a good, that is good.
King John Lackland was really good friends with William Marshall, who was the first Earl of Pembroke. Hmm. In fact, on King John's deathbed, he named William Marshall as King's Counsel to serve as protector over 9-year-old King Henry.
Sounds like the first season of Game of Thrones.
Right? Only King John was the villain in the Robin Hood stories, and he most likely dined in the Great Hall at Pembroke.
This is awesome. This is the cave down at the base of Pembroke Castle. All the great castles were built against a bay of the ocean to make it easier to carry in goods across the sea, bring them in here to a storage facility like this awesome cave. I can't stand it. It's so cool. I can't imagine how the ladies of the day would maneuver up and down these very narrow staircases in their dresses that they would wear, and even the knights and the gentlemen of the era with their swords and the things that they would have to carry going up and down these stairs. It's just impressive.
Just get a kid in the playground.
Yay! If you're keeping count, that was castle number 2.
Yeah, Wales has the highest concentration of castles anywhere.
Yeah, so naturally, if you're going to Wales, you're probably gonna go see castles.
Wales also has the highest concentration of Welshmen.
Who'd have thought? And Welshmen are hard enough to understand when they're sober.
Oh my God, when they're drunk.
Oh, wow. Are you recording? Hi.
Hi.
What's your name? We're in Cardiff with a drunk Welshman. Hey? How much have you had to drink?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Nothing to drink? What? Right on. Are you going to drink more?
Hey, you're just in there all night.
Say hi.
Hi.
He passed out on the train that night and ended up missing his stop. Took the train all the way to the end of the line, had to call his wife at 3 a.m. to come pick him up.
Oh my goodness, but we didn't get drunk. Nope, we were up bright and early to go out and explore and see more castles. So after this car comes, we should be getting a green light, and it goes yellow before it goes green to let us know that it's about to change. See? Green?
Oh, this guy's just gonna die.
Let's turn out for him.
Should we make him go over? This is the moment in the horror movie where that person tells us, don't go! You're all gonna die!
Oh, another one. Oh, you're on the wrong side.
Yeah, I am on the wrong side.
Stupid Americans. Well, look how beautiful that is, though. We would have missed this coastline.
Wow, that is really pretty. And there's the beach. You want to go swimming? Oh, this now it's even more narrow.
And cars now, coming.
And a car's... Oh. People must get killed on these one-lane roads all the time.
Maybe that's why cemeteries and churches are aplenty.
Maybe. Here we are at Manorbier Castle. It is really pretty from the outside. This would have been the drawbridge area, and they have one of those big iron gates that would have come down. In ancient times, this castle, part of its defense system would be a moat that would go all the way around the castle. Also, so that visitors that were welcome could enter the castle, there would be a drawbridge here that would rise and lower as needed to let people in. This is a super medieval pathway that maybe many of the...
That was castle number 3.
And for castle number 4, we storm the castle.
This is Carew Castle. It is said to be haunted by the lady of the house. Also, it is said to be haunted by an ape. The owner of the castle had an ape, and he got into a feud with another lord of the time, and so he sent his ape on the other lord, which the ape killed the other guy, but then turned around and killed the owner of the castle. Just goes to show you, don't mess with great apes. Don't do it.
Okay, stop. That could be a 70s Welsh folk rock album cover.
That's for sure. Now let's see some real ancient history.
It's only like this big.
We visited 2 6,000-year-old burial chambers.
The first, the Pentre Ifan, is the best known, and because of its height, it is the most impressive megalithic monument in Wales.
But first, we had to get there.
There's the ocean way out there. Ah, beautiful day.
The Neolithic tomb is of portal dolmen type, with the front of the chamber composed of three large uprights.
The burial chamber was once partially covered by dirt and rocks. It extended 120 feet to the rear.
This megalithic structure was erected in 3500 BC is the estimated date. That's insane. That is absolutely just crazy. The rock that's on the top there is 3 tons. How, in that day and age, would they be able to erect this? That's just the manpower, the strength, I mean, how? That would be built, and then the remains would be placed inside, and then the entire thing would be covered over in dirt. And we will see an example of a completed burial chamber a little later on. At any minute, this 6-ton rock, actually, this is a 3-ton rock, this 3,000-pound rock could just fall on my head. But you know what? It's 6,000 years old, so it probably won't. Next, we drove 130 miles to see a completed burial chamber, the Brandsefan.
I have no idea. We'll write it right here. It's too hard to pronounce.
Yeah. People between these two locations most likely traveled by sea.
Or by spaceship. The Pentre Ifan burial chamber is actually located 4 miles inland. And with this other one being 130 miles away, the only way for these two to be similar is if these two lands had communicated with each other.
Yeah, so?
So, if they communicated with each other, then that means they had language. And we know they could write because they had carvings. So that means there were texts. But these texts don't exist. So the only logical explanation, without having texts, is that these things were put here by aliens.
Okay. We're on a path to see an ancient burial chamber.
It's like 6,000 years old here on the island of Northern Wales, Welshland. Are you excited about seeing something that
is thousands of years old?
Predates Christ, right?
Yeah, a couple thousand years before Christ.
So this could have been put here by like aliens.
Maybe.
They say Stonehenge is only like 2,000 years old and it was done
so
by...
So this predates Stonehenge.
This predates Stonehenge.
This is the completed chamber, much like the one that we saw earlier. It's unknown how many people were originally laid to rest here. The tomb lay open for, I don't know how many years. I said many people have left offerings in remembrance of the ancients. Said that
This is supposed to represent a woman's pubic mound, and that when people are laid to rest, they are re-entering the womb, and that is why we have this big dome shape.
So if this is the entrance to the vagina, then the anus is on the other side?
You're silly.
Let's go find the clitoris. That's weird. So these are either the pee holes or the clitoris. Then if we enter down the canal, this must be the G-spot. That might be the anus.
It's got these ancient markings. It's very old.
So if that side's the entrance, what is this side?
It is a sealed up portal.
It isn't sealed. There's a hole right there.
Well, it's almost sealed.
Hole right there.
Not going there.
Poke your finger in the hole. What is that hole?
It's where the spirits can enter and leave as they wish.
Oh, the spirits can enter through the back door?
Yeah. If they want.
Would that rock be a poop? So what'd you think?
I thought it was pretty cool.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was pretty neat.
Did it change your life?
I wouldn't
like
say
really,
that.
Am I going to run into something?
No, not yet. You're going pretty straight.
Those burial chambers are pretty epic, but I'm pretty sure they were put there by aliens.
No, they weren't.
Yeah, that would explain the Welsh language and the town names.
We are at the train station of the town with the longest name, and that would be it. And I can't even pretend to try and pronounce that. I'm now going to attempt to pronounce it. Lanbir. Pool Gwyn Gil Gogur Uquern Drabul Landus Ilio Gogo Gotch. Goat.
Not bad.
Well done. Gwynen Canvair Pwch Gwyn Gich Gogeri Gwyn Drobich Candis Ilio Gogo Gotch.
All right, now you.
Canvair.
Huh?
Canvair. Pwch Gwyn Gich. Well done.
Woo! Now say it fast.
Oh.
You.
After you.
It means St. Mary's Church in the hollow of the White Hazel near a rapid whirlpool and the Church of St. Tislow of the Red Cave.
Well, okay then. That's what it means. Crazy.
Wow, you did a good job pronouncing that. Maybe she's an alien.
Whatever. We visited the town with the longest name, so it would stand to reason that we'd also visit the smallest,
This is the smallest house in Great Britain, and it's located here in the beautiful town of Conwy. Look at this.
It says you're making the beans. You're making the beans.
It's tiny! Smallest house in Great Britain.
My hand is bigger than this house. Small house, big house.
Which one's the castle?
Trying to find the castle?
Yeah, where's the castle? I don't get it. Oh, there it is. We are now in the town of Conwy. Behind me is Conwy Castle. And what is so cool about this is the walls actually go around the town and you can actually walk the walls. So you can go from point A to point B simply by walking the castle walls that surround the town. It is way cool.
Holy crap, this is quite a kingdom.
It's amazing.
Could you imagine keeping this house clean?
Oh my God, no.
How many maids would you need?
About a million.
That's a lot of maids. I don't think a million maids would fit here. This town ain't big enough for a million people.
Oh, well, but it is big enough for us.
Oh, yeah. This is your kind of castle?
Yes.
Oh, I see.
My kind of kingdom.
Maybe one day I'll buy this city for you.
Okay.
Yeah, I doubt it.
I will be Princess of Conwy.
Princess of Conwy now?
Yes, Wales.
Whatever. That was castle number 6.
Actually, 5.
They all start to blend together.
No, they don't.
Like a frappuccino.
Starbucks in Bridge End.
Ooh la la. We're at Brecon Beacon National Park. Behind me is a really cool cave with a really fast moving river that's going under this mountain in this cave. There's spiders and creepy crawlies, and I'm not going any further. Water's probably freezing. There's some really cool orb weaver spider webs in there too. I got a neat picture of one. And according to the sign, danger, danger. Deep water in the cave is dangerous and many people have drowned. So don't go swimming. Behind me is the opening to a really big cave. Brecon Beacon, there's an underground system of caves, and it's really pretty. Let's go take a look. It's really cool in here. You can hear the rushing water and some trickling water, and there's really big roots that are coming down out of the cave, the ceiling of the cave, and it's really kind of eerie and spooky, and it's really neat.
That was actually pretty frightening.
Yeah, 11 people have actually died in that cave. They've drowned to death.
Yeah, and when we were there, it was really pretty, but we weren't prepared to go caving.
No, that's why we just stayed on the outskirts and took some photos. But it was still dangerous, because you could slip on a rock and get swept away with that water and just end up in a dark abyss of death.
Yeah, and that would be suboptimal.
Yeah, dying is suboptimal on your vacation.
Or any time.
Or any time, really.
We are here, next to this lonely phone booth that's in the middle of nowhere, up in Brecon Beacon. Just driving along, little old red phone booth. It's very cute. There's lots of spiders in here. I'll stay out here.
I was actually surprised to see those phone booths still in use.
Me too.
They're like a stereotype of Europe.
And the stereotype is true. We're here at Coity Castle, right?
Yeah.
Coity Castle. Really cool ruins here to explore. Walls.
That was castle number 17.
Six.
Six, 17. What's the difference?
We are at Candleston Castle. And be careful because there are adders about.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? We've already done this bit.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
What do you want to do now?
I don't know. Why do you want me to come over here?
I don't know. Say something cool.
I'm gonna cast some mother.
Pop tip, mother.
Pop tip.
See?
Come back, my prince. My prince. There it goes.
The dungeon.
So cool. I love it. In the master's quarters, as it is the only one I believe with the loo. Beautiful Candleston Castle. Maybe they used to make candles here. That's why they called it Candleston.
Castle 37.
Number 7.
Quite an interesting and hard training. You come down here like on a Saturday and it's packed, rugby players, different people training. So we'll walk up.
I can do this. I can do this.
Oh. I'm currently training for the running of the bulls on the Big Dipper.
I did it. I'm so ready for this. No bull's gonna catch me. I hope.
Victory! Victory!
Michael is gonna run with the bulls in a couple weeks in Pamplona, Spain.
Yeah, it's crazy. I told him that we would get him to the hospital after the bull gorges a second butthole in him, and then we would fly home.
Yeah, pretty much. Perfect countryside. Beautiful. These are the king's royal steeds. And one is coming to say hello now. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
You are gorgeous.
Yes, that's your good boy. That's your good boy. Yeah. Yeah. Hello. Your good boy.
It's a little known fact that the American Indians actually were here before the castles. But you can see the teepee ruins over there.
Those teepees were weird.
What's weird is your irrational fear of walking on wet rocks.
You could slip, bump your head, and die, which is suboptimal.
Vince had to save her.
Put your foot in the crevice in the middle.
My balance sucks. Don't understand.
You can do it!
I know, I'm aware.
Yeah, 2 seconds.
Did Ogmore Castle ever come under attack? Yes, it did. In fact, the first ever recorded mention of Ogmore refers to the Welsh threatening to attack the castle in 1117. We know Griffith ap Rhys ap Tewdwr, future prince of Deheubarth, led the Welsh army. Nearly 300 years later, in the early 15th century, Owain Glyndŵr's War of Independence reached Ogmore Castle. Glyndŵr's campaign to make Wales an independent country was gathering momentum, and Ogmore felt the full force of it. Over 20 years later, a 1428 survey reveals the extent of the damage. The castle of Ogmore is not worth as much as it costs in repair because it was destroyed in the time of the rebellion.
We're here at Ogmore Castle.
Oh, that's it?
Well, she's not a historian, she didn't know that.
You guys were the ones listening to the recording. This was built by William the Conqueror about 900 years ago, and he had it built for his family because he was a Norman lord who was invading Wales, and in order to protect his family from the Welshmen, who are very upset about being invaded.
How dare you? Come here.
They're attacking, see? We have a live play going on behind me. He had this castle
I will
built
kill you. You
to protect
mine.
Him from
Where's
the Welsh.
Mine? Oh, all right, let's keep going.
From the Welshmen that were revolting William.
He's cut, and it's a bad cut. That was a bad
cut. Cut me.
That was castle number 99.
It was not, it was 8. Or was that 7? Or 8?
She can't even remember.
We are here in Bridgend at an old POW war camp for Nazi high-ranking officials.
This is one, I think this is the one I need. It was the biggest escape attempt made by German prisoner wars in Great Britain during the Second World War. German officers escaped, I'm not sure how many, but they dug a tunnel and got under the fence and escaped into the sand dunes, basically Merthyr. And I think they did catch them all eventually, but a policeman helped them when they broke down because they spoke such well English that one of the Welsh policemen fixed the car for them so they could make the getaway. The list of former inmates includes many senior SS military leaders. Pretty nasty people, eh? So the Hut 9, this is, so look now, it's got hut9.org.
Hut 9 is open like once a year, and you need to check the website to find out when.
Yeah, it's too bad, because the place would make an awesome year-round museum. Mm-hmm.
Welsh church out in the countryside. This one is said to be haunted by the White Lady.
So that's Graveyard 2 in Castle 9.
Actually, that was Ewenny Priory.
What's a priory?
It's a monastery.
Oh, a pretzel factory.
Huh?
Monks make pretzels.
Here we are at Newcastle in Bridgend, Wales. Let's go in and take a look. Can you tell where there's some restoration?
Maybe that's just stonemasons were perfect and got it perfectly flat.
That could be.
This is Newcastle.
This is Newcastle, that is correct.
Maybe they were going after the Newcastle look. Mixing with the old.
You're good.
like castle renovations.
There you go. There you go. Not much is left of what was once, I'm sure, a magnificent residence. This, I think, is the 10th castle that we've seen during our visit to Wales. Wales has more castles per square foot than anywhere else. Many of them may be in ruin, but there's still a good sense of history to them all. Castle number 9.
Yeah, it was undergoing some home renovations.
I wonder if they had a Home Depot in the 1100s.
Wouldn't they just sell rock?
Probably.
As time ticks by, be prepared for highly offensive language, full frontal nudity, and adult chat.
So we're Big Brother fans, and while we were in the UK, their version of Big Brother was on, and we got to watch it.
Yeah, and they have nudity on their TV, on public television for everybody to see. I thought that was a stereotype, but it's actually true.
Nick is trying to convince Harry to join the party.
You coming for the show, team?
Yeah, but I'm in the back.
Can you rush that? You could get out.
Get, what, get out, sit there in my f***ing towel, and then get back in the back?
Yeah.
Is it now?
If you want to pop a towel on, and then come out and watch, okay.
There's nudity right there. There's boobs and bush right on the telly for everybody to see. It's awesome.
I don't behave like that. That's not the way I am. But I like him.
Head by head. The all of his head. We all had to lick. Good on you. Good on you.
She's mad. What? I love it.
She's got
Why
a muffler.
Not, you know,
we've all F***ing hell, mate. She's got a baby rat. Clitosaurus. F***ing hell.
Saggy. Just wait till the lights have gone off. Get your f***ing burgers away.
Here we are at the Old Stone Bridge at Bridgend. Built in 1425.
Redone in 1775.
And it was redone in 1775. That's still pretty old. Do we have anything that old in America? I think not. Maybe just Maybe. So that was Wales.
Yeah, if you enjoyed that, then be sure to subscribe so you'll always be notified of our next video.
Yeah, we're also going to be visiting France, Belgium, Netherlands, and Spain.
And England. Once it's done, that video will be right here.
Click over there.
Yeah.
And until that's done, you can check out some of our other videos over here.
Our other Life Doesn't Suck travel videos will be over there.
Yeah.
So subscribe here.
Subscribe. England when
England
it's ready.
England when it's done.
Yeah. And our other Life Doesn't Suck, because it doesn't. Life doesn't suck. Yeah.
So you got all these options.
Yeah.